let's have a look at some of the basics of moving around the sequence and navigational tools. You can drag the positioner all over the sequence to display the current frame in the record viewer. If you want the positioner to jump to another point in time, you can do it in two ways. Just click the timecode bar at the bottom of the sequence, and the positioner will jump to that point in the edit. Clicking in the scrub bar below the source or sequence viewer will do the same thing. To navigate to a specific timecode, click on the timecode indicator and type in the timecode. After pressing enter, the positioner will jump to that specific timecode in the sequence. You can also make the positioner jump a few frames forward or back relative to its current position. For example, click on the timecode indicator and type 5. You now press the add or sub button to move the positioner forward or back. Press enter. The positioner moves 5 frames forward or back from its original position. If you're using a keyboard with a number pad, you don't need to click on the timecode indicator to move the positioner. Just type plus 10 and press enter. The positioner will move forward by 10 frames. You can also make the positioner repetitively move by a number of frames. Click on the timecode indicator. In the calculator, type 5 frames and press add or sub repeatedly to continue to move the positioner by 5 frames. Press enter to close the calculator. Looking at the positioner, you will see a small horizontal bar. This is called the focus point. You will discover it has many functions in the sequence, and this function is track navigation. Pressing the up and down arrows on the keyboard, you will see the positioner moving from one cut to another along the track aligned with the focus point. So moving the focus point up and down between the tracks allows you to choose which track to navigate. If you want the positioner to navigate every cut on every track, you can force it to do so by pressing Ctrl up arrow or Ctrl down arrow. In a long or complex edit, you may want to focus on specific points of the sequence to do some detailed work. There are a number of ways you can zoom into the sequence, and everyone has their own personal favorite. The first method is to click on the horizontal scroll bar and drag upwards. The upward movement zooms into the sequence. Dragging downwards zooms out. To fit the sequence to the timeline view, you can click the home icon located to the bottom right of the sequence or press Shift Z. You can also press Shift Z to toggle between the previous zoom and fitting to the timeline view. You can also use the rectangular zoom tool by pressing Option Z and dragging a box to zoom into the region of segments. Now hold Ctrl and Option and click and drag to gesturally zoom the timeline view horizontally. Lastly, for a more conventional way to zoom in and out of the sequence, press Command plus to zoom in and Command minus to zoom out. The pull-down menu at the bottom right of the interface gives you various options to fit the timeline. You've already used the home option, which is zoom to width and height. The second is to reset the track height. The third is only to fit the width of the sequence to the timeline view and not affect the track height. The fourth and final option is to zoom to a selection of segments in the sequence. To pan the sequence left or right, you can use the horizontal scroll bar at the bottom of the timeline view. Or you can press Ctrl Command and gesturally drag the view to the left or right to scroll the sequence. The vertical scroll bar also has two functionalities. You can click and drag it left or right to increase or decrease track height. And also, as expected, you can scroll the sequence vertically to show the other tracks in the sequence. You can also use the middle wheel of a 3-button mouse or your Mac's trackpad to vertically scroll the tracks. Please move on to the next video to continue your smoke getting started experience.